Hey all, welcome back to another session of Social Science. I am Kavita here to present and as well as to continue the next part. This is the last session of this lesson. As we know, we discussed about so many aspects in the second video. In that, we discussed about Tipu Sultan. Who is he? He was the son of Hyderabad. That during the second Anglo-Mysore War, Hyderabad was died, so that war was continued by Tipu Sultan. And third Anglo-Mysore War, fourth Anglo-Mysore War. After end of the fourth Anglo-Mysore War, the rebellions or protests against the British, the later part of the 19th century, among them we discussed about rebellions in my second video, that is Dhondiabad. The rebellion of Dhondia was the brave and warrior rebellion in Karnataka. He was the born in the Maratha family of Chennai. His title Wag in a sense title. And after end of Dhondia war, again rebellions were started with the Kitturu region, in Kitturu Prince state. So the rebellion of Kitturu was started. In that we discussed about Queen Chennamma and as well as Sangoli Rayanna. So why Kitturu, why Chennamma fought against the British? Because she adopted a child. So that after defeating so many wars, British brought many changes in their administration. They introduced so many policies on the Indian kingdom because to control Indian princely state. So that they brought many changes in their administration. And as well as she adopted a child according to Lord Dalhousie policy. Lord Dalhousie's policy, doctrine of lapse. According to his policy, no adoption. But although she adopted a child. She adopted a child because of Shivalinga Rudra Sarja, who was the son of Chennamma. After death of Shivalinga Rudra Sarja, she adopted a child. Shivalingappa. So she adopted a child, Shivalingappa, he became the ruler of Kitturu. So each and everything report, when she adopted a child, Thackeray had given the report for the government of Bombay. Who is Thackeray? Thackeray was the agent and politically agent of Dharwad region. So when Chennamma adopted a child, that report was given by Thackeray. Yavage Chennamma ondu maguna dattu tagontade avage enagutte antandre aa ondu report na yaru government of Bombay ge ondu report martali Thackeray. Thackeray yarli, he was the politically agent of Dharwad region. That report was given by him. The later on, the British declared a war against Kitturu. She fought against the British, and later on, so till now, Chennamma name has remained in Karnataka history. And his fame, along with Chennamma, we heard the name, the brave warrior in the Kitturu region, that is Sangoli Rayanna. So Sangoli Rayanna name has remained along with Chennamma. So he was a very brave soldier, a very warrior. He fought against the British because for his motherland, Kitturu. These are all the concepts we discussed in the previous video. Today, I am with the continued part and this is the last session of this lesson. In today's session, we are going to learn on these main topics. Those are rebellion of Amara Sulya, rebellion of Surpur and Koppal, and rebellion of Bedas of Kalagari. These are all topics we are going to learn in today's session. Let's start our class with the rebellion of Amara Sulya.
So let us discuss about the rebellion of Amara Sulya. Then what was the reason to start rebellion in the Kodagu region? Then who started the rebellion against the British? So these are all the concepts. Now we are going to learn on the concept the rebellion of Amara Sulya.
So this rebellion was basically a farmers' rebellion
and this rebellion needs to be understood in the backdrop of political situations prevalent in coastal Karnataka and Kodagu region during 1835 and 37. So the British dethroned the rulers of Kodagu, Chikadevaraj of Haleri dynasty in the year 1834. He was later transferred to Vellore through the Bangalore and later to Kashi. This incident created the political instability in Kodagu. Then Swami Aparampura, Kalyana Swami and Puttabasappa organized a rebellion against this. It's as I told now, the rebellion of Amarasulya. Basically, this rebellion was a farmers' rebellion. Andre raithara dange anta naavu karithivi illi. Yaake agutte antandre because of politically situation the coastal region karavali tira pradeshadalli mattu Kodagu ondu bhagadalli sambandha paduvanta ond dange agide adu yav time alli antandre in the year 1835 and 37. And the main thing here, the British andre Britisher en maartare andre chikka devaraj avarna ಒಂದು ಸಿಂಹಾಸನದಿಂದ ಕೆಳಗಿಳಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ದಿಸ್ ದ ಮೇನ್ ರೀಸನ್ ರೆಬಲ್ಡ್ ಅಗೇನಿಸ್ಟ್ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್. ಯಾವಾಗ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷರು ಚಿಕ್ಕದೇವರಾಜ್ ಅವರನ್ನು ಸಿಂಹಾಸನದಿಂದ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಇಳಿಸ್ತಾರೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗದಂಥ ಜನರು ಅವರ ವಿರುದ್ಧ ದಂಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಅವಾಗೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಅಂದರೆ ಚಿಕ್ಕದೇವರಾಜ್ ಅವರನ್ನು ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರಿಂದ ಕಾಶಿಗೆ ಸ್ಥಳಾಂತರ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಇದೊಂದು ರೀಸನ್ಗೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಡಗು ಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷರ ವಿರುದ್ಧ ಒಂದು ದಂಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಈ ದಂಗೆಗೆ ಪ್ರಮುಖ ಕಾರಣ ಕರ್ತವ್ರು ಯಾರಂದ್ರೆ ಮೇನ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ದನ್ ಹೂ ಟುಕ್ ದ ಲೀಡರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರೆಬೀಲಿಯನ್ ದ ಕೊಡಗು ರೀಸನ್ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಅಪರಾಂಪುರ, ಕಲ್ಯಾಣ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪುಟ್ಟಬಸಪ್ಪ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸ್ಡ್ ದ ರೆಬೀಲಿಯನ್ ಅಗೇನೆಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಅಪರಾಂಪುರ, ಕಲ್ಯಾಣ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪುಟ್ಟಬಸಪ್ಪ ಟುಕ್ ದ ಲೀಡರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರೆಬೀಲಿಯನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕೊಡಗು ರೀಸನ್ all the three declared that they are the part of the Haleri dynasty that ruled Kodagu, and the Swami Aparampura assumed the leadership of the rebellion. Then who took the leadership of the rebellion in the Kodagu region? Swami Aparampura. So he was captured in 1834 and shifted to Bangalore. And similarly, Kalyana Swami also captured in the year 1837 in the place of Mysore region. And yavage idu rebellion start aagta barutte, so ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಅಪರಾಂಪುರ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಚರ್ ಇನ್ 1834 ಅಂದರೆ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಅಪರಾಂಪುರ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷರ ಸೈನ್ಯದಿಂದ ಅವರನ್ನು ಸೆರೆ ಹಿಡಿಯಲಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅವರನ್ನು ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿಗೆ ಶಿಫ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ದೈರ್ 1837 ಕಲ್ಯಾಣ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಚರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಆರ್ಮಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮೈಸೂರ್ ಪ್ರಿಸನ್. ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ನೋ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಪುಟ್ಟಬಸಪ್ಪ ದೆನ್ ಹೌ ಪುಟ್ಟಬಸಪ್ಪ ರೆಬೆಲ್ಡ್ ಅಗೇನೆಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೋವರ್ ಕೊಡಗು ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಡ್ ದ ರೆಬೀಲಿಯನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಲ್ಯಾಣ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ. ದ ವೆನ್ Kalyana Swami was captured by the British army in the year 1837 and sent him to Mysore prison. This rebellion was continued by Puttabasappa. It means the people of Lower Kodagu continued the rebellion after the capture of Kalyana Swami. And Sulya, Beleri and Puttur, the major place of Kerala region, were part of Amarasulya. It means these three places were under Amarasulya. It is very interesting note and very interesting matter here that a farmer named Puttabasappa as a Kalyana Swami. The later on Puttabasappa, he became Kalyana Swami. The Puttabasappa later presented himself as Swami Aparampuram. His character has changed here. And then Puttabasappa ye naagutane adu Kalyana Swami aagi change aagutane as a farmer. The later this Puttabasappa later presented himself as Swami Aparampuram. So the Puttabasappa took over the leadership of the rebellion. It means entire the rebellion was under the leader of Puttabasappa. And the later on, this rebellion started in the hill region. The Puttabasappa declared that tax on tobacco and salt will be withdrawn if the rebel government assumed power. The rich farmers and the landowners and as well as the local chieftains were assured of this move. ಅಂದರೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ದಂಗೆಗೆ ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಜನ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪುಟ್ಟಬಸ ಡಿಕ್ಲೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪುಟ್ಟಬಸಪ್ಪ ದ ವಿತ್ಡ್ರಾ ದ ಟೊಬ್ಯಾಕೋ ಆನ್ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ ತಂಬಾಕು ಮತ್ತು ಉಪ್ಪಿನ ತೆರಿಗೆ ಮೇಲೆ ಏನಿತ್ತು ಅನ್ನೋ ತೆರಿಗೆ ಅದನ್ನು ವಿತ್ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಸೊ ಹಿ ರೆಬಲ್ಡ್ ಅಗೇನೆಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಗೌರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಲೋಕಲ್ persons. It means the rich farmers, landowners, and the local chieftains were assured of this move. ಅಂದರೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ದಂಗೆಗೆ ಇವರು ಎಷ್ಟು ಸಹಕಾರ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಪುಟ್ಟಬಸಪ್ಪ ಕೀಲ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಮಲ್ದಾರ್ ಹೂ ವಾಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಬ್ರಾಟಿಲಿಟಿ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ದ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲಾರಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಪುಟ್ಟಬಸಪ್ಪ. ಅಂದರೆ ಪುಟ್ಟಬಸಪ್ಪ ಅಲ್ಲೊಬ್ಬ ಅಮಲ್ದಾರ್ನ ಒಂದು ಸಾಯಿಸ್ತಾನೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಕ್ರೂರತೆಗೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ದಂಗೆಗೆ ಒಂದು ಯಾರು ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರನ್ನು ಪುಟ್ಟಬಸಪ್ಪ ಅಮಲ್ದಾರ್ ಒಬ್ಬ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿನ ಸಾಯಿಸ್ತಾನೆ. So this incident gained more support and for the rebellion, and the rebellion became more famous. The rebels marched towards Bangalore too and captured it. The British were engaged in the fortifying their fort in the Mangalore region. The rebels marched towards Mangalore through Panimangalore and Bantwal. They looted the treasury and the prison of Bantwal. The British sought the army Talcherry, Kannur and Bombay to quell this uprising. On hearing all this development, Puttabasappa and his associated fled towards Sulya. ಅಂದರೆ ಪಲಾಯನ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಇಷ್ಟು ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಷ್ಟೆಲ್ಲ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಆರ್ಮಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಪುಟ್ಟಬಸಪ್ಪನನ್ನು ಮತ್ತು ಅವನೊಂದು ಫಾಲೋವರ್ಸನ್ನು ಫಾಲೋ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ. Because of all this development, Puttabasappa ran towards Sulya. The British captured them with the help of people in Kodagu. So, Britisher en maartare andre sthaliya ondu janara ondu sahayana padibittu avaranna capture maartare. The Puttabasappa, Lakshmanappa and Kedambadi. So, these are all persons' death. Though the rebellion failed, but it has an important place in the history of rebellions against the British. So this is the concept how Puttabasappa rebelled against British in the Kodagu region.
Next move on, another most important rebellion in Karnataka state, that is rebellion of Surpur. Yes, Surpur, it is there in the present day of Adigiri. It's away from 50 km from Adigiri. So, Surpur, it is there in the present day of Adigiri. Just it's away from Adigiri, it is only 50 km. And Surpur, it was the most important prince state during the Mughal dynasty. As I told in the first video, when Aurangzeb was died, Mughal dynasty had lost their political power in the Karnataka region. See here, Surpur, it was the most important prince state during the Mughal dynasty. When Mughal dynasty had lost their power in the Karnataka region, during that time, Nizam of Hyderabad and Marathas, during that time, it became vassal state of them. And then later, most of the territory was lost, most of the prince states were lost, and Surpur had become a remain restricted prince state in Karnataka. And in Surpur, Venkatappa Nayaka had rebelled against the British, so that we call a rebellion of Surpur. In Surpur, who fought against the British? That is Venkatappa Nayaka. Yes, let us discuss about how Venkatappa Nayaka had become rebel against the British. See here, Venkatappa Nayaka, he came to the ruler of Surpur after death of his father Krishna Nayaka. So here, they lecture, Venkatappa Nayaka became the ruler of Surpur after death of his father. His father named Krishna Nayaka. And then, Venkatappa Nayaka, Surpur na ruler akinta munche, yaaridralli Krishna Nayaka. Krishna Nayaka yarani? Krishna Nayaka was the father of Venkatappa Nayaka. So, after death of Krishna Nayaka, who became the ruler of Surpur? It is none other than Venkatappa Nayaka. So, Venkatappa Nayaka became the ruler of Surpur and he was born in the year 1834. So, Venkatappa Nayaka was born in the year 1834. When he became the ruler of Surpur, just at the age, at so early age, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅತಿ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ವಯಸ್ಸಿನಲ್ಲಿನೇ ಅವನು ರಾಜಾ ಆಗ್ತಾನಲ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಅಡ್ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಸುಲ್ಪುರಿಸಮ್ ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ವೆಂಕಟಪ್ಪ ನಾಯಕ ಬಿಕೇಮ್ ದ ರೂಲರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸುಲ್ಪುರ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಏಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಅಗಿ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಅಡ್ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಹಿ ಬಿಕೇಮ್ ದ ರೂಲರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈಲ್ ಸುಲ್ಪುರ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಅಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಬೈ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ನಾಯಕಾಸ್ ಬ್ರದರ್ ಪೆದ್ದ ನಾಯಕ When Venkatappa Nayaka became the ruler of Surpur, it was completely opposed by Pedda Nayaka. Who is he, Pedda Nayaka? Pedda Nayaka was the brother of Krishna Nayaka. Here they are. Krishna Nayaka, Pedda Nayaka, you two brothers. Okay, na? So, after death of Krishna Nayaka, who became the ruler of Surpur? It is none other than his son, Venkatappa Nayaka. At a so early age. When Venkatappa Nayaka became the ruler of Surpur, who opposed Pedda Nayaka? Then who is Pedda Nayaka? Pedda Nayaka, he was the brother of Krishna Nayaka. These are all the internal clashes took in the Surpur region. The clashes took among them. These two clashes, the British got chance to enter the Surpur region. So, clashes took among them. ತಮ್ಮ ತಮ್ಮ ನಡುವಿನಲ್ಲಿನೇ ಅದು ಜಗಳನ್ನು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಲಿ ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಫುಲ್ ಕ್ರಾಶಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ದೆನ್ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಚಾನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸುರ್ಪುರ್ ರೀಜನ್ ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಆಫೀಸರ್ ಅಪಾಯಿಂಟೆಡ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಅಪಾಯಿಂಟೆಡ್ ಟೈಲರ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲಿ ಏಜೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸುರ್ಪುರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ 1842 ಇನ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ 1842 British appointed Tyler as the political agent of Surpur region. Because of why he appointed? Because to maintenance. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ವೆಂಕಟಪ್ಪ ನಾಯಕ ಅತಿ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ವಯಸ್ಸಿನಲ್ಲಿನೇ ರಾಜ ಆಗಿರ್ತಾನೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಯಾರು ಅಪೋಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪೆದ್ದ ನಾಯಕ ಇದಿಷ್ಟು ಕ್ಲಾಶಸ್ ಆಗಿರೋದಕ್ಕಾಗಿನೇ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷರು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಒಬ್ಬರನ್ನ ಅಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ ಯಾರು ಅಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಟೈಲರ್ ಇಂದ 1842 A British appointed Taylor as a political agent and gained prominence over in the Surpur region. So Taylor was the reformer in the Surpur region. He developed the Surpur Prince State in all the field. And as well as Pedda Nayaka was appointed as the Diwan of the state. So when Taylor became the political agent of the Surpur region, So he was a reformist entire the Surpur region. Yavage politically assigned aagi Taylor appoint aagtane idi Surpur na tumba development maadta hogtare. So he developed Surpur Prince State and Pedda Nayaka was appointed as a Diwan of the state. Pedda Nayaka en maadtane andre oba Diwan aagi ond appoint aagta bartane. Taylor had reformed agriculture land and every sector. And as well as Taylor given education for Venkatappa Nayaka. Venkatappa Nayaka mattu Surpur na pratiyondu hantadalli sudhanayana tannanta vyakti yaru antandre is none other than Taylor. So Taylor was a prominent person in Surpur region to develop in every field. Pratiyondu kshetradalli Surpur na ondu development maaruvanta vyakti yaru antandre Taylor. And as well as Taylor was the main person to provide education for Venkatappa Nayaka. So, later on, Venkatappa Nayaka became the power in the year 1853. So, in the year 1853, Venkatappa Nayaka came into power in the Surpur region. Again, once I'm repeating here. So, Venkatappa Nayaka, he came to throne after death of his father, Krishna Nayaka. Krishna Nayaka. Venkatappa Nayaka was born in the year 1834. So when Venkatappa Nayaka, the ruler of Surpur, at so early age, but it was opposed by his uncle, who is Krishna Nayaka's brother, his name Pedda Nayaka. The clashes took among the in Surpur region. The British appointed. Person, it is none other than Taylor. So in the year 1842, British appointed a person, his name Taylor, as a political agent and as well as power of overall Surpur region. And Taylor was the real major reformer, the supervisor. He developed Srutu in every sector. And as well as Taylor was the person to provide education for Venkatappa Nayaka. And later on, Venkatappa Nayaka became the real ruler of the Srutu region in the year 1853. Here, when Venkatappa Nayaka became the real ruler of Srutu region in the year 1853. So before that, he was the very early person, was very child. So that it was not able to administration from him. So that British appointed as the person, as the politically agent of the Srutu region, his name Taylor. And the later on, Venkatappa Nayaka. So Venkatappa Nayaka became the real ruler of Srutu region in the 1853. And his aim to free from the British. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಅವನು ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಮಗು ಆಗಿದ್ದಾಗ ರಾಜ ಆಗಿದ್ದಕ್ಕಾಗಿನೇ ಟೇಲರ್ ನ ಅಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಸೊ ಮುಂದೆ ಹೋದಂಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಾವ್ಯಾಕೆ ಅವ್ರ ಅಡ್ಡ ನಿಲ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಸುರ್ಪುರ್ನ ಅವರಿಂದ ಮುಕ್ತ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಅವರಿಂದ ಫ್ರೀ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಅವರು ಡಿಸೈಡ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವೆಂಕಟಪ್ಪ ನಾಯಕ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ರೆಬಲ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್. ಸೊ ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸುರ್ಪುರ್ ರೀಜನ್. ವೆನ್ ವೆಂಕಟಪ್ಪ ನಾಯಕ organizing the Srutu region, when he was started to plan organizing the Srutu region and rebel against the British government, these are all the politically activities development were observed by the British government. So then in the year 1857, it came to the notice of the government. That report was given by Nana Saheb. He was the representative person in Srutu region. In this two development act ide Srutur nalli Venkatappa Nayaka ee riti maartta idan antheli aa report na government ge yaar handle maartali Nana Saheb. So Nana Saheb was a president in Srutur, the representatives of Nana Saheb. That report was given by the representative of Nana Saheb in Srutur. ಇಷ್ಟು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ, ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷರ ತಂಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಆ ಒಂದು ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್ ನ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಗೆ ಯಾರು ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ಹೇಳಿ, ನಾನಾ ಸಾಹೇಬ. ಸೊ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಟಿವ್ ಆಫ್ ನಾನಾ ಸಾಹೇಬ್ ವಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸುರ್ಪುರ್. ದ ಲೇಟ್ ಒನ್ ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಅಪಾಯಿಂಟೆಡ್ ಅನ್ ಆಫೀಸರ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇನ್ ಕೆಪಬಲ್. ಸೊ ಕೆಪಬಲ್ ಟು ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್ ವ್ಯಾರಿಯಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಲೇಟ್ ಒನ್ ವೆನ್ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ದ ಗಾಟ್ ಈಚ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸುರ್ಪುರ್ ರೀಜನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ವಾಸ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್, ದ ಲೇಟ್ ಒನ್ ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಅಪಾಯಿಂಟೆಡ್ ಅನ್ ಆಫೀಸರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಟು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲಿ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸುರ್ಪುರ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇನ್ ಕೆಪಬಲ್. ಸೊ ಕೆಪಬಲ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅಪಾಯಿಂಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಟು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲಿ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸುರ್ಪುರ್ ರೀಜನ್. The later capable he gave a report. The officer submitted a report to the notice Hyderabad of Nizam. And the later on, the British got the real intention of Venkatappa Nayaka. These two report noted mele British are the real intention gotta gatte ivara uddesha yenu anta heli. The later on, Venkatappa Nayaka is usually presented as the leader of the 1857 revolution in Karnataka state, because as we study 1857, the first war of Indian independence in Karnataka, the real revolutionary person, it is none other than Venkatappa Nayaka. So it is because Venkatappa Nayaka intention to free Srutur, to free from the British, Srutur na or the muktara maadbeku tanna ondu princess state yara ondu kelagade irbaru antu heli Venkatappa Nayaka British ayira tangi helta martane. So Venkatappa Nayaka is a real person. 1857 revolution in Karnataka state. The British army captured Srutur in the 1858. Then at present Venkatappa Nayaka has remained in the Karnataka history. It means in the 1858 Srutur came under British rule. So this is the concept, the rebellion of Srutur, the against British. Next, move on. Another most important rebellion in Karnataka state, that is rebellion of Koppal. Here, rebellion of Koppal is an important rebellion in the various armed rebel against the British. So, Koppal rebellion is the most important rebellion of against the British, and Koppal and most of the surrounding regions were under Nizam of Hyderabad, and Nizam of Hyderabad and his followers were exploiting the farmers and exploiting the peoples. It was not tolerated by the Koppal region people. So that Koppal region people and the surrounding the geographical people were rebelled against the Nizam of Hyderabad. Among them, Veerappa, he was the Jamindara. He rebelled against Nizam of Hyderabad. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕೊಪ್ಪಳ ಮತ್ತು ಕೊಪ್ಪಳಕ್ಕೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟಂತ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಪ್ರದೇಶಗಳು ಯಾರ ಅಂಡರಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತವೆ, ನಿಜಾಮ ಹೈದರಾಬಾದ್ ಅಂಡರಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತವೆ. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಜಮೀನ್ದಾರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪೀಪಲ್, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟಾಲರೇಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಜಮೀನ್ದಾರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್. ಅವರ ಒಂದು ಶೋಷಣೆ ಇವರು ಸಹಿಸಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗ್ತಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಅವರ ಒಂದು ವಿರುದ್ಧ ಯಾರು ದಂಗೆ ಎದ್ದಿರಲಿ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಅದರ್ ದೆನ್ ವೀರಪ್ಪ. ಸೊ ವೀರಪ್ಪ ಆರ್ ರೆಬಲ್ಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದ ನಿಜಾಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈದರಾಬಾದ್. And the Veerappa was the Jamindara and rebel against the British and occupied Koppal fort. The Veerappa, he was the Jamindara of Koppal region. He rebelled against the British and occupied the Koppal fort. Koppal fort ena vashapadisukuntane, and many farmers and Jamindaras were supported to Veerappa. The late they got realized as a motivator. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅವನಿಗೆ ವೀರಪ್ಪನಿಗೆ ಆಗಿನ ತಕ್ಷಣವೇ ಯಾರು ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ದ ಲೇಟ್ ಶೋರ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಜಮೀನ್ದಾರಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ವೀರಪ್ಪಸ್ ರೆಬಲ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ವೀರಪ್ಪನ ಒಂದು ದಂಗೆ ಆಗಿರ್ಲಿ, ಒಂದು ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಗೊತ್ತಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಅವಾಗ ಯಾವಾಗ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಲೇಟ್ ಶೋರ್ ದ ಮೆನಿ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಜಮೀನ್ದಾರಸ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದ ವೀರಪ್ಪ. The late shown the British contacted Nizam of Hyderabad because these are all the politically activities of Koppal region, and the late shown Veerappa who had the lesser soldiers and fighting the British army. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ವೀರಪ್ಪನ ಹತ್ರ ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಮಟ್ಟದ ಸೈನಿಕ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಹಿ ರೆಬಲ್ಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಡಿಫೀಟ್ ದ ಫೈಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಆರ್ಮಿ. ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಚರ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಫೋರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೊಪ್ಪಳ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್, ಅಂಡ್ Koppal came under the British rule. And till now, Veerappa name had remained in the Karnataka history. So this is the concept about Veerappa of Koppal. And the next move on, the last concept from this lesson, the rebellion of Bedas of Kalagar. Then, how Bedas were rebelled against the British, and what was the reason for the to fight against the British? ಯಾಕೆ ಹಲಗಲಿ ಬೇಡಾಸ್ ಅವರು ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷರ ತಂಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ವಾಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್? ದ ಹಲಗಲಿ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ವಿಲೇಜ್, ಸೊ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ವಿಲೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಮುಧೋಳ ತಾಲೂಕ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬೆಳಗಾಂ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮುಧೋಳ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ಇನ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ 1857 ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ ದ ಟ್ರೈಬಲ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಅವಾಯ್ಡ್ ಯೂಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆಪನ್ಸ್, ಯೂಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಮ್ಸ್. In the year 1857, British government and British East India Company had given order to all the persons whoever had arms and weapons. 1857 ಏನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷರ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಏನಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಯಾರ್ಯಾರ ಹತ್ರ ಶಸ್ತ್ರಾಸ್ತ್ರಗಳಿದಾವೆ ಅವರೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಆ ಶಸ್ತ್ರಾಸ್ತ್ರಗಳನ್ನ ನಮಗೆ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಓವರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ ಟು ಅವಾಯ್ಡ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ದ ಯೂಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆಪನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ 1857 ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಈಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಕಂಪನಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಟ್ರೈಬಲ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ಸ್ ಹೂಎವರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ವೆಪನ್ಸ್, ಹೂಎವರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಮ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಓವರ್ ಟು ದ ಕಂಪನಿ, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಟು ಯೂಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆಪನ್ಸ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಆ ಒಂದು ವೆಪನ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ಆರ್ಮ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ನ ಆಗಿರ್ಲಿ, ಶಸ್ತ್ರಾಸ್ತ್ರಗಳನ್ನ ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಓವರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಕಂಪನಿಗೆ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಓವರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಮತ್ತು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದನ್ನ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ದ ಬೇಡಾಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ಬೇಡಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಕೆಪ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ವೆಪನ್ಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಕಸ್ಟಮ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗುಡ್ ಹಂಟರ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹಲಗಲಿ ಬೇಡಾಸ್ ಒಂದು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಬೇಟೆಗಾರಾಗಿರ್ತಾರೆ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗುಡ್ ಹಂಟರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ಡ್ಯೂಟಿ ಟು ಹಂಟ್ ದ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್. ಅವರ ಒಂದು ವೃತ್ತಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಪ್ರಾಣಿಗಳನ್ನ ಹಂಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಅದನ್ನ ಬೇಯಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ತಿನ್ನೋದಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. where in the 1857 what they passed order they to stop uses of weapons andre weapons na use madodana stop maadri ante heli british government avaru en maartare antade avaru order helte it was completely opposed by halagali bedas so that halagali bedas were rebelled against the british that questions will come like this why halagali bedas had rebelled against the british because in the year 1857 british given order to the beda tribal peoples to stop uses of weapons to avoid the uses of weapon and to have to hand over to the weapons to the company so that halagali bedas were rebelled against the british so this is the concept the rebellion of bedas of halagali so by this concept today we have completed the lengthiest lesson that is unit 4 opposition to british rule in karnataka so